Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to my video. So it's kind of a dreary day out right now, and just went to pick up some stuff and got back to my car. Noticed that my car is not starting. It's just clicking, which I'm kind of confused at what the issue is at this point. I did leave my lights on overnight a couple days ago. Had to get a jump to get it started. But I don't know if that's what's causing my issue at this point. So I did a couple of tests and everything seems to work. The lights on the dash seems to work. The battery turns on. The radio turns on. The blower motor turns on. I can feel wind coming out from the vents. Yeah. So outside of that, the only problem that I have is the engine isn't starting. It's not cranking. It's not turning over. It's just one single click. You know, every time I try to turn on, it's click, click. That's all I hear. Sometimes I don't even hear that. I don't even know if the click is coming from, I'm just a little bit confused on that. So, what I did was I did try to get the car jumped. Some guy tried to give me a jump. And it didn't turn over. It did the same thing. It clicked. The car didn't crank at all. I didn't even hear a slow crank on the engine. So it pretty much means that there's either no power getting to the starter, or the starter is the starter is not working. So what I did was I did open the hood up, obviously, before I got it jumped. I was doing a couple of things. I checked to see whether the terminals were rusted or had any kind of debris on it. It was kind of dirty. I did unscrew the connections to the terminal and clean that up a little bit with a paper towel. Try to wipe some of it off. I kind of spray some WD-40 on it, try to wipe some of it off. I actually had a can of soda also, and I poured some soda on it, pretty much wiped it off with, some paper towels. It's a lot cleaner than it was before. It's pretty clean now, to be honest, and it should be making good contact. To be honest, I don't think it's the battery, considering when the guy, put the cables onto the car, it should have just started up right away, even if the battery was 100% dead. Well, let me backtrack. I've had situations where the battery was 100% dead, and, you put cables on it, immediately if you try to turn it on, it probably would do the same thing, click, or at least you would hear some kind of firing off or something like that. But he did leave on it. We did, have it left on for about 5 minutes, and took the cables off. And I didn't even hear a click. I heard a click, but I didn't hear anything outside of that. It wasn't anything kind of. I heard a click coming from it. But I didn't hear, any kind of cranking coming outside of that. So that was pretty, it was pretty disappointing, to be honest with you. So I'm stuck at this place. My car is not turning on. I'm not able to drive it. I'm hoping that it's not the starter, because then I'd have to get the car towed and have this starter replaced. And I really don't want to do that. So basically at this point, I am going to try to figure out a couple reasons of why it's doing that. I don't think it's the brake switch on this car, because I actually did, you know, try to figure out whether it was a brake switch, but it works. I mean, the brakes work, the brake lights work. So, you know, normally if it's the brake switch, the brake light would not work. So that would be an issue. It's not an issue with this, I don't think. So basically my problem is at this point, you know, trying to figure out, you know, whether it is, I know it's not the alternator. I'm hoping it's not the starter because I had the starter replaced last year. It was a refurbished starter, remanufactured, meaning that they actually cleaned up the, replaced the part that was broken on the starter and put the new part in. So at this point, you know, I'm hoping it's not the starter because then I'd have to buy, I mean, the starter is warranted for life, I'm pretty sure, last time I checked. But I'm have to get somebody to put to work on it, to put it in, and that's going to be costly too. So that kind of sucks. So my situation is, at this point, I am trying to figure out what else it could be. And like, it might be the fuses. It might have been the fuses actually, but it's actually not the fuses. I actually have a fuse tester to test out the fuses, and I went through each and every one of them, and the fuses work fine. There's no problems with the fuses. All of them were tested out and all of them worked fine. So next up would be the relay on the car. The relay. So I'm thinking, could it be the relay? Could it not be the relay? Which is a good question, because the relay actually relays, you know, that's what it does. It relays electricity from the battery to the starter itself. It relays the electricity from so if there's a disconnect on the relay, you're not gonna get anything going to the starter. And but I kind of ruled that out, because if I think about it, if you think about it, it's not gonna be the relay, because there's a noise that it makes. The starter has a solenoid on it, and once you turn the key, it clicks. And normally that click is the solenoid clicking. If it's clicking, it means that there's electricity going to the solenoid, which means that the battery is fine. Can't say that 100% for sure, but I'm pretty sure it's not the relay. Sometimes I've had situations where the relay, where, you know, my car would crank and it wouldn't turn over. Last time that happened, it would crank up, but, you know, it would start a little bit and it would turn itself off. I think that was the problem. I'm not sure, but I cleaned the relay and it actually worked, I think. But that was a while ago. I'm not sure. I don't think it's the relay. So what I'm going to, you know, there's nothing else I could check out, I don't think. There's really nothing else I could check out. The fuses, the relay, the battery is good. Somebody gave me a jump. You know, electricity was applied to it. I mean, so at this point, the only thing I could do is to go out and to try to bump the starter. And yeah, so I actually did bump the starter a couple of times. It's always best if there was somebody else to bump it and then you know, to start it. I bumped it a couple of times with crowbar that I have. It's long enough, and nothing happened. Actually, I tried it like 5 times just to bump it, bump the starter, bump the solenoid. And I actually did try to see if there was any kind of crud on the connection to the solenoid and to the starter motor. And it was kind of dingy and dirty, but I don't think that's going to cause I don't think in this case that's the issue of why it's not starting. Unfortunately, I think at this point I might have to call AAA and have them tow this car. It kind of sucks because, you know, now I'm going to have to find somebody to work on it. And it's just really, you know, it's really a waste of time. I mean, I'll probably take, you know, I'll probably try to take, you know, do some work on it myself, but it's just an absolute waste of time at this point. On top of that, the starter lasted me a year. Hopefully I can find a new starter on eBay, a used one where I could just get it off a junkyard or something like that, because even if this starter that I have, even if it's a lifetime warranty, I'm not going to be trusting, I am not going to be trusting remanufactured stuff anymore. I had a remanufactured alternator on my car and that thing died out within a year or two, so I had to change that like twice actually. And it worked out where I got an alternator from the junkyard, popped it in, and that has not failed me since. Crossing my fingers on that, but at this point I'm gonna get something from eBay. Hopefully I can get it from eBay, pop it in, and we'll get it to jump and to turn on and to work. And I mean, that's all I can do at this point. Okay. So here's the thing. I found out that it was the starter that was causing the issue with my car. It was the starter that was causing the issue with my car. I had my car towed. The starter was taken out. The starter was put back. You know, I was able to get a starter from an auction from eBay, from a junkyard. They're always posting the car parts on eBay. I was able to get it. Popped it in and it actually did work. So, and hopefully I won't be having any other issues with my starter, considering you know, this might be a used part, but well, hopefully I don't have this issue for a while. I mean, it might be a used part, but you know, at least I'll know that, you know, it is an OEM part, so at least I'll know that I won't have any other issues with it, I guess. Hopefully, crossing my fingers, you never know. But you know, I'll trust this more than I would trust a remanufactured starter. So, but hope this video has helped you guys out. If you can, please subscribe. Please, you know, give me a thumbs up. And also, please, if you guys have any comments, you know, leave a comment, feedback, anything. All right, guys. All right, guys. Take care.